Basically, the theoretical background of the study that will have the different components like Javier Frutos, Maria Marcos, Maria Piñal, Piñeiro, and José Gatos, the PhD director, the leader of the research, was powered by the background was the George Gadamer confirmation theory, and also associated to the concept that Morgan and Shannon have analyzed information with television being a cultural instrument able to shape consumptions and construct social reality. It's also true that it's necessary to analyze social matters and analyze television and analyze content. But my participation, in fact, in research was in the technological issues of how can we get the instruments, you know, under this theoretical background. Okay. The second part, and you have in the paper better analyzed, is the concept of prejudice. Prejudice as an attitude towards negation, we're analyzing. We have also to analyze that the intergroup contact or the indirect association to prejudice and to the symbolic analysis that has been analyzed by Clark may be reduced with a content analysis of what's seen in television as a content. Another idea is that television is acquiring a prominent role in the construction of identity, in construction, for example, of the message system analysis, or as you have in the other point here, you have in the indirect media content, and the construction and the reduction of prejudice in terms of that media is not neutral. Okay. We have also an analysis of the immigration, of the image and the invisibility of the immigrants, and the diversity that is distorted in terms of what content is in prime time, and specifically in prime time in Spanish television. So we did this analysis that was well analyzed by two of our colleagues that happened to be present here in the room, that are Pigatua and Lifen Cheng, in a study in 2009. There's also another analysis that we did, you have the mythology in the paper, that is associated to the fictional and dramatic shows, and what research is being done in the States in this line of analysis, and what we, to a certain extent, analyze in terms to corroborate some of the hypotheses we have in the study, in the idea of analyzing primetime fiction in Spain. Okay. So we go to the hypothesis, and trying to be synthetic. We have different hypotheses, but the main three hypotheses that I'm going to show you in the paper and the conclusions is that there was an underrepresentation of immigrant and foreign characters in fiction programs. Hypothesis number two was that immigrant and foreign characters will be shown more frequently as antagonists, as the bad ones, as the villains, as compared to the native Spaniards, so to say. And the third hypothesis was that immigrant and foreign characters will be shown as having lower educational levels. So they will be shown as more as villains and antagonists, but they will have lower economic, educational background, skills. They will be less skilled than the others. In fact, the results of the analysis have in the methodology they had a content, a sample of 2 weeks in this time span, 6 national channels in the digital terrestrial television in Spain, they were the generalistic ones. And we did an analysis, a group of work, which was a large group of workers and researchers, and people also did the content analysis, 75 fiction programs. The unit of analysis at the end with the definition that Goldman does of a character, that one that speaks within and has a line of content within the editorials for the series of the content analysis, ended up with 1,788 characters, which in fact is a relevant number, it's a significant number. The amount of work done was very relevant. There was, of course, the construction of a code book, which in fact here the methodological experts, Lifen, Juanjo, were constructing and corroborating and working that the methodology worked well. At the end, ended up with 52 variables. And basically, in the analysis of making the contrast of the three main hypotheses that we are going to show. Okay. The coding, as I said before, had 8 analysts that were formed and were trained to do this the coherent, intercoding coherence in terms of the analysis. That they were like methodologically speaking and coding that was very scientific in the method. Okay. But at the end, the results, what were the results? Hypothesis one, and I will read, is that there will be an representation of immigrant and foreign characters in fiction programs broadcast on primetime. In fact, there was, and the representation that you have, you may see here, in the programs produced in Spain, 4.4, and the programs produced that had an origin of the United States, an American origin, it was 8.3. So in fact, that was positively constructed. The second hypothesis was the one of immigrant and foreign characters will be shown more frequently as antagonists or villains, as the bad ones. In fact, they were the bad ones, because you see here, the red one shows all the immigrants, okay? Not being the bad one, but they were overrepresented, so they were more. You see here, this percentage you may see in the paper, twice more representation in terms of 6% and 12%. Hypothesis number three was that immigrant and foreign parents will be shown as having lower educational levels. They will be less formal, less educated. They will have, in terms of their education, a lower educational background, a lower also socioeconomic status, and also performing occupations that were low in terms of the average of the prime time series and the characters that were analyzed. That was, a margin of the characters that we were unable to identify, in fact, this part. But yes, in the part of illiteracy, the immigrants were more illiterate than the average of the series. But we have also to consider that to a certain extent, a large part of the immigration that we have in Spain is also immigration that, culturally speaking, are native speakers of Spanish. So the other representation may be, in this analysis, even higher to that certain extent. So the results, here is a socioeconomic status also. We did corroborate that immigrants were low in the representation. And the results in the analysis, in this team, this transformation, is that the immigrants in 21%, it showed involves criminal activities, more representation, other occupations. You may say here also in terms of the non-skilled workers, in terms of the reference, here you have all these statistics. Framework of the analysis that you may read in the paper and analyze. So this gives us the conclusion of the discussion. I hope to be on time and have exceeded. I try to be sympathetic and also take time with my colleagues. Well, there was, as I have said before, underrepresentation of immigrant foreign characters in programs produced in Spain, 9.3 versus 11.2. There was a low representation in terms of the disability. There was also a parasocial vicarious contact of the native population with characters from national origins. This was difficult to establish. The stereotypical and negative image of the immigrants, foreign characters, brings about reinforcement or assimilation of prejudicial attitudes towards immigrants. That was also analyzed and concluded. Media can therefore be an instrument, it is an instrument to change attitudes in a positive way as different actors or to encourage positive parasocial contact. So we have to evaluate, we have to measure, we have to identify these variables and also address and assess the producers and the content producers on the effects, but also on the content that they're actually producing and showing to the audience in the prime time in terms of the series. So there are also certain recommendations you will see in the paper in terms of the conclusions that are significant, that are relevant, in order to continue this line of investigation with the prime time in series, not only in the prime time maybe in series, but as we are doing in films or in other content, because it's relevant to evaluate and to address how the image and how the content analysis of this image and this data is being represented. Well, it's a pleasure for me to be here. Gracias por su atención. We're in Spanish environment. There you have the references and the emails for contact of Juan José Garco, who's the expert in the part of the mythology and more technological participant in the job. Here you have my email, and it was a pleasure. You can enter our project at ocausa.es, the Observatory for Audiovisual Content, which is the Observatory de Contenidos Audiovisuales. If there are any questions at the end, or there may be some email, it's a pleasure for me. Thank you.